TLO, what's poppin'? We are on Twitch. We are not live. But you can leave a like, comment, subscribe. Turn on your post notification bells. Let's continue to grow the family from Chicago to the UK. If we do go live, this is the channel. You can catch any highlights, things of that nature. Don't forget, we do got merch. You get me. And Patreon as well. We post Monday through Friday. We miss a day, we push it to the weekend. Mostly true. British cuisine, culinary atrocities. Wow. Okay. These are going to show British atrocities from food. Salute. Let's get into this. Let me see if I agree, man, because they be talking crazy about y'all food. But it's not really that bad.
Now, this, so my dad is from...
This is funny. Look at his teeth.
England, and so I was raised on some classic English food. My dad was raised in post-World War II Britain, a time period of economic decline, bread rationing, and the worst culinary atrocities known.
This is not bad, though. But why on wheat bread? That's not correct. It's white bread. White bread, butter, Heinz beans, put a little cheese, put a little Worcestershire sauce or brown sauce, and you good.
Demand. Many that still continue to this day. For number one, we have beans on toast.
I'm not going to let you disrespect beans on toast like that. Don't do that. Don't do that. Well, this is good. Americans can even do this. This is good.
Imagine this. You wake up on a Saturday when you're a little kid. You're pumped to watch some cartoons and maybe eat some pancakes. Oh, yeah. I'm about to put whipped cream and chocolate sauce on.
Stop. Hey, stop. I got real tears. That's funny. Go back to the edit.
Gotta put whipped cream and chocolate sauce on.
Oh man, that's funny.
See, back in my dad.
I'm not gonna hold you. That is hilarious. That edit was funny.
Dad's time, all they really had was bread and canned food. That was it. And there's not much you can do with that. So most of the meals people ate during that time involved bread, beans, tomatoes, and other food you can stuff in a can. And when you have a whole generation of poor fucks raised on this shit, they go and teach it to their own kids. And then their kids teach it to their kids. And then you end up with a whole subculture of British Instagram where people are posting breakfast pics of fucking beans on.
Or, in my case, an American who has adopted the culture and is spreading the grace of beans and toast.
Toast! And next we have banana buddies.
I had that. That's good. Don't lie.
Another abomination involving bread. This...
Bro just really don't like this stuff.
Time it's with sliced bananas between two slices of bread. It's literally just a banana sandwich. That's it. For number...
It's good, though. It tastes good. They complement each other.
Number three, we got bacon buddies. Now I...
This is also good.
Swear by bacon buddies. You got bacon. You got toast. Combine the two, bacon buddy. This legendary meal is always there for me after...
Yeah, that's tough. That's it. Everybody does this.
Night out drinking. And next, we got cheese toasty. And yeah...
It's just a grilled cheese.
Yes, this again is just a cheese sandwich. But when your country was...
A cheese sandwich and a cheese toasty are two different things. I feel like a cheese sandwich is not toasted bread, not melted cheese. Cheese sandwich is just bread and a slice of cheese.
Bombed for 8 months straight. You gotta make cheese sandwich sound a little more positive and fun. But let me break down this naming system for these foods. Or rather, the lack of sensical naming system. So apparently it seems like buddy is just British slang for sandwich or between two slices of bread. You know, you got the bacon buddy.
That's toast. Why is he showing bread? Why is he showing toast for bread? Bread and toast do not even taste the same, even though it's the same thing, but they don't even...
Banana buddy. But then that begs the question, what the fuck is up with cheese toasty? Why did they break the naming?
Because the bread is toasted and not untoasted.
convention. Banana buddy, bacon buddy, cheese toasty? Why not cheesy buddy? No one knows.
Because that would be an untoasted. You know what?
People start drinking in England at the age of 12. Who gives a shit? No rules. And then we have black pudding.
This is good.
Piece of shit food is a delicacy over in England, and it's literally beef blood and fat mixed with oatmeal. They were really running out of ideas with this
pork blood
one. For number six, we have spotted dick. This is
thumbnail. You get me?
What happens when your main tool for cooking is a giant cauldron? You just throw in some dough, add in some water, and fuck it. Some of that leftover, dried out, rotten fruit you forgot about last week. It got its name because, well, British people think dicks are funny. Hey man, you know what would make the-
Is that really what the reasoning is? Wait, why is spotted dick called spotted dick? Like, it doesn't even make sense for it to be called that. Blemished Robert? It's tough.
These tasteless, flavorless, bland peas way better if we mushed them up so they-
Yeah, this is bad. I hate it.
They look like fucking baby vomit. Oh, dude, I have an even better idea. What if we did that and then we put them on top of French fries? This is why countries raise the drinking age, so we don't have an entire-
That looks disgusting. Thumbnail option number two.
Generation of people who think mushy peas are an acceptable thing to dip French fries into. Like, seriously, what is this? Get this out of my sight. For number eight, we got toad in the hole. Now this is a
this is actually good. I wonder, he's definitely tried it before. This is good though.
Perfect example of the laziness that lost Britain the great empire it used to have. You know how if you're from USA, you've probably had pigs in a blanket or some form of sausage wrapped in dough? Well, apparently they're too good for that over there. They can't be bothered to individually wrap sausages. And let me explain something. The benefit of-
Yes, they do. Greg's, they got sausage rolls.
Of wrapping them individually is the ratio of sausage to dough. If you just toss some sausages in randomly into a pan of dough, what if there's a whole section that's just dough? You don't want to take a bite of something and have it be just-
But it's Yorkshire pudding. It's okay if it's just dough because it's good. It's gravy. Dip the dough in the gravy by itself.
Plain dough. Next is pot pies. Now this is the one thing England has going for it. When it comes to pot pies, England is the champ. There's really no competition. Last time I went to England, I got a beef pie in a random little shop on the street, and it was straight up an out-of-body experience. Well, anyways, that's all I got for today.
Yeah, no, that was like good.
Thanks for watching.
I'm not gonna lie, this was hilarious. TL, leave a like, comment, subscribe, turn your post. I am ineffectively gone.